We're going to solve a problem using two variables. Ben buys two hats and five scarves in a store for $111. Jose buys four hats and three scarves in the same store for $103. State the cost of a hat and the cost of a scarf. Okay, the clue here is that we're looking for the cost of a hat and a cost of a scarf, so let's define our variables by the cost of a hat and the cost of a start. Cost of a scarf. How about H will be the cost of a hat? And how about S will be the cost of a scarf? I think I'll change that to X because some people might think my S is a 5. So how about X for the cost of a scarf? All right, first let's see what happens to Ben here. He buys two hats and five scarves. All right, so he buys two hats. Each hat costs H dollars. So he pays 2H total for the two hats. Plus, he also has to pay for the scarves. He bought five scarves. Each one costs X dollars, right? Or we don't know if it's, well, we're going to assume that's in dollars, but it could be dollars and cents. So that could be 5x. And the total amount he pays is $111. So this first equation tells you what Ben pays. Now let's look at the second equation. Jose. Jose buys four hats and three scarves. So he pays 4h for the hats. Right? Four hats, H dollars each. And he buys three scarves, so we have to add the cost of the scarves, 3, times the cost of each scarf is X, and that's $103. All right, not easy to solve for H or X, so the substitution method doesn't look like the way to go, and I certainly wouldn't want to have to do this by graphing, so I'm going to go ahead and use the addition method. I'm going to move this over a little to the right so there's some space. Okay, so let's see. We would like to either have the H's or the X's cancel out. So notice 2 goes in to 4. So if I just multiply the top equation by negative 2, I'm going to get it. In fact, I'm going to multiply the top equation by positive 2 and the bottom equation by negative 1, and I'll tell you why I'm doing that. Because I know when I multiply 2 times 111, it'll make it positive, and then I'll be subtracting the 103. If you had multiplied it by negative 2, you'd have the negative number on top. Either way, you will end up with the same thing, so you might do it a little bit differently than me, because there are several ways to multiply the equations by a number to get the x's or y's to cancel out. So I'm going to do 4h plus 10x equals to 22, and negative 4h, remember you have to multiply both sides of the equation, every single term by negative 1, so it's a negative 4h, a minus 3x equals negative 103. So let me just state this again. If I would have multiplied the top by negative 2, all the negatives would be in the top equation, and all the ones at the bottom would still be positive. When you add these two together, though, this way I have a positive in front of the x. So I have 7x equals 119. Let me just divide by 7. So x is going to be 17. All right, what did x stand for? Oh yeah, the cost of the scarf. So the cost of the scarf looks like it's going to be $17. Now I need to find the cost of a hat. So I want to take either of these two equations. I'll take the top one, 2x plus 5x equals 111, 2h plus 5x equals 111, and I'm going to plug in 17 for x. So 2h plus 5 times 17 equals 111, and that way I'll be able to solve for h and know the cost of a hat. So I have 2h plus 85 equals 111. Then we can subtract 85 from both sides. And that gives you 2h equals 26 Divide both sides by 2. So h is 13. Aha. So the cost of a hat must be $13 if we did this right. And that's what we're looking for, the cost of one hat and the cost of a scarf. All right. Now, you would have gotten the same answer if you had plugged in 17 into the second equation, the 4h plus 3x equals 103. All right. So now we want to make sure these answers make sense given the original problem. So here's the original problem. Here's what we got for the cost of a hat and the cost of a scarf. So we're hoping that this is going to be the correct answer right here. Remember, h and x are not part of the problem. You're the one who said just called the cost of a hat h. So the cost of a hat's $13, cost of a scarf $17. Now let's check and make sure that's true. So originally it said Ben bought 2 hats and 5 scarves. Okay, 2 hats. All right, how much did he pay for a hat? $13. So he paid $26 for a hat. And let's see, what else did he buy? 5 scarves. Each scarf was $17. And so he paid $85 for the scarves. And so he paid $111. And yes, that checks out for Ben, right? So Ben checks out. Now let's check Jose. Jose's costs. He bought 4 hats. Okay, each hat was $13. So he paid $52 for the hats. And he bought 3 scarves. Each scarf was $17. So he paid $51 for a scarf. And if we add that up, let's see, we get $103. And yes, it does state that he spent $103. So it checks out that that was the correct amount that Ben would have spent, correct amount Jose would have spent. So therefore, this is our answer. The cost of a hat is $13 and the cost of a scarf is $17. Here's what you could do. Write this problem down on your own piece of paper. Wait a half an hour and do it all on your own. See if you get the same answer.